obviously we take the handbrake off.
Okay, so let's do a bit of spreading then.
Right, I'm knocking this right down into lowest gear because it's pretty thick stuff, so it's slow coming out. 540 RPM. Registering any speed on here, I don't know why that is, I'm just doing more than that. And you can see it coming out very slow.
To muck spreading again, and to be honest, I don't mind this sort of job. It's not stressful. It's kind of like you can sit here. Normally, I've got the radio on because I listen to the radio when I'm doing a job like this. But I obviously put it off because otherwise, it's a bit too noisy on the video. And we're just literally dumping this muck on the field now, and you can see it starts off pretty slow. I mean, I've loaded up the muck spreader quite full, and it takes a while for the flails to get going and chucking it all out, really. And gradually, as it empties out, it comes out quicker and quicker. So you wouldn't say it's necessarily the most accurate way of putting the muck on, but really, I'm just interested in covering the field. So we're coming up here by the second pile there. And you can see now it's coming out a bit faster now. Lovely stinky stuff. Oh, I'm spreading it on the actual pile. I don't really want to do that. Let's move over out of the way a bit. See where I took the last load. Too worried where it goes because it'll all get pretty well covered on the field in the end. I think we're at the end now. Here, a couple of the flails are a bit long, they're clunking away, so just knock that back, wet that off, and then we're off. Change gear into higher gear. Oh, here we go, and we're off. Don't really like this gear stick very much, a bit of pain. Let's go! Come on! Muck on! Muck on! Muck on! Come on, let's muck on! Keep going. Muck on. Thank you. Here we are then, that's the last bit of muck behind me. Oh, I got dirt on the lens. Hope you can see that, okay? Very windy out here, but it's annoying when you get the wind noise on the film, but there's not much I can do about that. So, I've got this load out. Just got this bit here to do. A few bits of nettles and stuff on the top, but that doesn't really matter. But it is beautiful, beautiful muck. I just had someone come and pick some up for takeaway for their tomatoes. And you can see the odd worm in it as well, look. So this is rocket fuel for tomatoes and hopefully rocket fuel for the maize. So I've just literally got to put this last bit in. I've gouged a bit of the soil out, unfortunately, here. But that won't really matter. By the time it's ploughed up, that'll be levelled back in and you won't even notice that. I might even level it with a bucket later as well. So I've just got to get this last bit in the tractor. Here goes. That's it then. So that's this pile of muck done, and I'm going to go up the field now and do the second pile, but I'm not going to film that because it's basically the same as this really, but plenty more muck to put out on the farm later, but some of it's in a muck pile that's got a lot of water around it, so I'm crouching down because it's been set a bit low on the tripod. But anyway, another bit of muck on the ground. I love muck spreading! Woo! That's it, the last load's up, been done, and I'm heading home. So that's two muck piles done, and you can see it all on the field here. So next stop for this field will be the maize.